Hello students, how have you been? And we meet again after the vacations, long time, isn't it? So now we're going to start a grammar lesson, and that is pronouns. Now we had done nouns before that, isn't it? So now we are going to do pronouns today. And we all know, we've learned in our previous classes, that a pronoun is a word that replaces a noun in a sentence. So pronouns are actually used to avoid repeating the same nouns over and over again. Now let us see a sentence in which we are going to use only nouns and no pronouns. How does it look? Let us see that. Okay. Here, I have a paragraph for you which has no pronouns. Let us read and feel how does it sound? A paragraph without pronouns. Mohan and Mohan's sister were feeling bored in the vacation. So Mohan and Mohan's sister's mother suggested that Mohan and Mohan's sister could go to visit Mohan and his sister's uncle's house and play Mohan's sister's and uncle's favorite game. Isn't it funny? Really funny, isn't it? Now let us see whether by using pronouns, if it sounds a little better. Now this paragraph, I have written it for you. Mohan and his sister were feeling bored in the vacation. So their mother suggested them to go and visit their uncle's house and play their favorite game. So much simpler to understand, isn't it, students? So now we understand why we actually need to learn pronouns. So we're going to now find out how many types of pronouns are there. Like we had a lot of nine types of nouns. Now we are going to find out how many types of pronouns are also there. Fine. Okay, the first pronoun that we are going to learn about is the personal pronoun, the most commonly used, often used pronoun. We use it all the time. Now, before we understand what a personal pronoun is, we also need to know about the person, means whether we are talking in the first person, a second person, or a third person. Now, look at that picture animation there, cartoon below. See, you can see the girl says, the girl is the speaker. There's only one person who is the speaker, and that is the first person. The person who speaks is the first person. I'm talking to you about him. So who is listening to that girl? The one with the cap, a red cap. A boy with a red cap is listening to her, and so he becomes the second person. The person to whom she is speaking becomes the second person. And then who is the third person? Look at that naughty little guy over there. He looks very naughty, isn't it? With the yellow hair. Now he is the one whom she's talking about to the boy who is beside her. So he is the third person, the naughty boy with yellow hair. He may be present, he may not be present at the time when the first or this and the second person, they are conversing with each other. When the first person is talking to the second person, they need to be there, maybe on the phone or maybe in front of them. But the third person may be present there or may not be present there, but it is always referred to the person whom they are referring to, the speaker is referring to. So I'm sure you are clear with this person, first person, second person, third person, because to understand personal pronouns, you need to understand this first person and the second person and the third person. You will see in the next chart, which I have got for you. In the grammatical sense, a personal pronoun is a pronoun that is related mainly to a particular person. And that's why it's called a personal pronoun. Now, generally, personal pronouns are only not limited to people. It can also refer to animals and objects. Remember, when we had done nouns, we had spoken about the neuter gender. It, yes. So, even personal pronouns can be referred to an object or an animal. Okay. Now, what are the subject pronouns? Now, the subjects are I, you, we, he, she, it, they. So, it could be an object too. Now, what are the object pronouns? Me, you, us, him, her, it, and them. So, these are the objects. Like, you know, in a sentence, you have a subject and you have an object. The subject is the doer of the action. Object is the receiver of the action. Yes? Fine. So now, Look at the singular and the plural. We have done numbers in nouns. So here also there are numbers in pronouns because they are replacing nouns. So if nouns have number, then pronouns will also have number. If nouns have gender, then pronouns will also have gender. Have you understood, students? Now look at this. First person. First person, subject pronoun is I, object is we. Second, that is this is all singular. First person, second person, singular is you, you. And third person singular is he, she, it, him or her or it. For example, let me give you a sentence. I am happy, you are happy, okay? And the third person, he is happy, she is happy, it is happy. So, it depends on the subject and the verb. The verb will have to agree with the subject. So, the verb keeps changing. So, we are going to do the subject-verb agreement later. So, when we do that, this has to be very clear. The person has to be very clear. That's why I clarified this here. Now, let us look at the plural. First person, plural, we. It's not I anymore, we. And second person plural is you. Because even you can be referred to one person. When there are three people in front of you, you can also refer to them as you. We don't say you all. That's wrong, students. We just say you. All of you, you could say, but not you all. Fine. Now, third person is they. So, they is the third person plural. So, is this clear? These are the personal pronouns that we are going to refer to. When we are talking about a personal pronoun, we always use it many a times. It, we have to be very careful with the word it. When it is referring, when it is used as a pronoun and when it is not. Fine. So, here you understand there are two sentences. It is a beautiful gift. It is raining quite heavily. Which one is a pronoun? It's very clear. The first one. Because it is a beautiful gift. You are referring to a gift. Probably your father has given you a beautiful toy and you are very happy and you find it very beautiful. So you are referring to that toy. You're referring to that gift. So that is a pronoun, it. But here, what is it is raining quite heavily? It is not referring to any kind of object. So, here it is not a pronoun. So, this concept should be very clear. When you're using it, use it consciously, students. Fine. Now, we move on to the next kind of pronoun, which is the possessive pronoun. Now, remember, in nouns, again, see, nouns and pronouns have to be similar because nouns are always placed in the place of nouns. So, if noun has a case, then pronouns will also have a case, and that is the possessive case, the possessive pronoun. Can you note one figure of speech here? The possessive pronoun. Yes, I'm going to ask you in my class. Yes, when we're going to discuss pronouns, the possessive pronoun. Which figure of speech is there in this title? Fine, I'm sure you've guessed it, but still, I'm not going to tell it to you. Fine. So now let's concentrate on what is a possessive pronoun, very much like the noun, a word that replaces a noun and also shows ownership. It has to show that it belongs to me. For example, this book is mine. Is that yours? This is his book. This book is hers. And these are, this is ours. Okay, this is ours and it is theirs. All these are possessive pronouns. For example, it's written over there. It's not yours. It's mine now. Now here, there's one line of caution, my students. Many a times, you know, children always get a little confused with possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives. There's a very little hairline of difference. So I thought, because this is a very common confusion, let me clear it out for you. It's there in your book also. If you want, you could refer to your book also. But I would like to clarify what is the difference between a possessive pronoun and a possessive adjective. Okay, so I have a few more sentences for you with the possessive pronouns before we move on to the difference between possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives. So first look at the possessive pronouns. Her parents were far more liberal than mine. You probably picked up my keys instead of yours. You probably picked up my keys instead of his. Your account of events does not correspond with hers. Your dormitory is no better than ours. His view eventually prevailed over theirs. Our house is not comparable with yours. So mine, yours, his, hers, ours, theirs, yours are all possessive pronouns. I would like you to have a look at one more thing. Please observe this, students. None of these possessive pronouns have an apostrophe. Did you find an apostrophe? So, because they already show possession, an apostrophe is supposed to indicate possession. For example, you say Rohan's book. So we say Rohan apostrophe S. Why are we putting that apostrophe S? To show possession. Remember we had done the possessive case in the nouns? But for possessive pronouns, we will not use any apostrophe because they are already in the possessive case. Mine, yours, his, hers, ours, theirs, yours. We will not use the apostrophe. Will you remember the students? Now, recently we had done the informal letter and there most of you have signed up as yours lovingly. How many of you put that apostrophe there? Think. Yes. Now you'll know whether you've done the right thing or the wrong thing. Because possessive pronouns will never ever take an apostrophe. Now let us come to the difference between possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives. Now, let me ask you a question. I'm sure you will all remember and you will all think, oh yes, I know, I do this all the time. I always make this mistake. For example, whose book is this? Whose book is this? And immediately say, ma'am, 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 it's mine, it's mine. You don't say, it's mine. You say, it's mine. But actually, are using a possessive adjective when you should be using a possessive pronoun. Remember, adjectives will always, remember you have made the parts of speech poem. Yes, in that, in the parts of speech, interchanging of parts of speech, I'm sorry, we didn't do the parts of speech poem, we've done the alliteration poem, but you have learned how to change from one part of speech to the other and how to identify adjectives. Adjectives will always have a noun after that. My book, our school, your camera, his uncle, her book, its tail, and their knowledge. So this is all possessive adjectives. They will always have a noun after it. But can we have nouns after pronouns? Yes, isn't it? We are using pronouns to avoid using nouns. Why will we have to put again? Yeah. So keep this in mind, students. Never ever make that mistake. Whenever you have to use possessive pronouns, you will have to use only the possessive pronouns. Whose book is this? Ma'am, it is mine. Will you remember that? Yes. And whose class is this? It is ours, yours, his, hers, its, theirs. You will not use possessive adjectives when you will have to use possessive pronouns, and you will not use an apostrophe in the possessive pronouns. These are the two things that I want you to remember, and these are the most commonly made mistakes when you are using pronouns, especially the possessive pronouns. Okay, let's move on. After possessive pronouns, we come to relative pronouns. Now, relative pronouns, by the word itself, it's very suggestive. It shows the relation. So a relative pronoun refers to a noun mentioned previously. So when you want to refer back to a noun, you use the relative pronoun. And there are different types of relative pronouns: who, which, that, whose, where, when, and there's one more, whom. Okay. Now, what is who? Who, it is used to refer to people. Which, is referred to animals, objects, or ideas. Now, these two are very confusing. Many a times, students often make mistakes here. Always remember, students, who is for a human being, for a person, for people, and which is for animals, objects, ideas. Get this very, very clear. Let me take you to the example on the right. This is a boy, he is my friend. Now, this from this particular pronouns, you generally get to join two sentences. This is how you might be tested on relative pronouns. So, for example, this is a boy, he is my friend. These are two separate sentences. Look how easily they are joined by a relative pronoun. This is a boy, who is my friend. So, you're using who for the people. Now, but when you're using which, it is for the inanimate object. There is a park in New York. It is a Central Park. The park which is in New York is Central Park. Clear? Which is for things, who is for people. Next, we come to that. That can be used for people, animals, or objects. This is something which you can relate. For example, this is a man. He lives across the street. This is the man that lives across the street. You could use that for a human being. At the same time, look at the car. I bought the car yesterday. Look at the car that I bought yesterday. Isn't it? So, you can use that for both people and things. Next, whom. Now, this is not there in the list on the left, but here I have people, object, preposition. For example, this is a boy, I want to see him. This is a boy whom I want to see. When I want to see somebody, this is the boy whom I want to see. This is a boy, I want to speak to him. This is a boy with whom I want to speak. Okay, so whom do you want to speak to? I want to speak to the principal, for example. So, whom is for a person generally. Now, whose? Now, whose shows possession? For example, this is a boy, I borrowed the book. This is a boy, whose book I borrowed. Now, here, whose, spelling of whose does not have a double O. Keep that in mind. This is where you make a mistake. Whose will always have one O. Whose. Fine. Next one. Where. This is the house I lived when I was a child. This is the house where I lived when I was a child. So here where is actually showing the relation. It is referring back to the noun. That is a place where I used to live when I was a child. And when will show the time. Where is place? When will be time? So it will always, I will always remember, it is not it, I, it is a printing mistake. I will always remember the day we met that day. I will always remember the day when we met. It's not jab we met, it is when we met. Clear? Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Now, this is the last type of pronoun that we are going to learn today. And that is the interrogative pronoun. Now, interrogation, from the word itself, again, it's very suggestive. It's a question. Very good. Interrogative sentences you've learned. So, you must be knowing what is an interrogation. Interrogative mark, that is, it's question mark. So, interrogative pronouns, all of them will have a question. Who, whom, which, whose, where, when, why, what, how. All these are interrogative pronouns. See now, but we have used the same word. Some of these interrogative pronouns were also relative pronouns. So, how is it different? Very simple. When we use it with a question mark, it's an interrogative pronoun. When we say it without a question mark, it is a relative pronoun. All these are WH questions. For example, I liked the cake which my mother baked yesterday. Here, do you have a question? No, it's not a question, it's a statement. So it's a relative pronoun. It's joining two sentences. But here an interrogative pronoun, it will ask a question about animal or object. Which cake did you like? The cake which my mother baked yesterday. So that is the difference. So who will be for a people, for people, whom, questions about people, which, again, who and which, I remember. I told you about it. Who is for people, which is for objects and animals. Whose is again possession. Where is about place. When is about time. Why is about a reason. What is about asking questions about things. What is your name? How will be asking questions about manner. How did you do it? What is so funny? Why are you laughing? When did you do it? Where did you keep it? Whose book is this? Which cake did you like? Whom are you scared of? Who is going to find out the vaccine for coronavirus? Yes. So these are all interrogative pronouns. Okay. So we learnt about personal pronouns. Remember, the personal pronouns are the most common pronouns that we always use, and in personal pronouns we also discussed about the person, first person, singular person. Then we also talked about the number, first person, second person and third person, and we spoke about gender and number. Next we come to possessive pronouns, where we spoke about ownership, and we also learned about identifying between possessive pronouns and possessive adjectives. That is the very, very important thing. Please revise that carefully. And we have also learned about relative pronouns. That means which shows a relationship, which means when we are referring back to some pronoun, to a noun, then we use the relative pronoun, and we also use it to join sentences. Very good. See, you remember everything. And the last one is the interrogative pronouns that we have learned. Mostly they are relative pronouns, but they all end with a question. So therefore they are interrogative pronouns. Most of them are those WH questions. Clear, students? Okay, that's all for today, students. Next class, we shall learn about reflexive, indefinite and demonstrative pronouns. That will be the end of the lesson of pronouns. Okay, so revise the class, revise the lessons that we have done right now, and do the questions that I have given in the practice questions section.